My name is TGV. I live in the Rittenhouse Gardens building on Chestnut Street. I'm 36 years old. I believe in daily self-care and I eat a sensible diet, along with a diligent exercise routine. In the morning, if my face is a little puffy, I will put two wristwatches over my eyes that are chilled in the fridge overnight. I then engage my core with some high-intensity stomach crunches. I can do several now. I skip weights so my wrists remain extra slim to comfortably fit vintage watches. In the shower, I like to sing the tenor parts from my favorite operas. Instead of dropping hundreds of dollars a month on artisanal body scrubs, spa cleansers, and salon brand shampoos, I prefer to save that money and spend it all on watches. On the face, I always use a moisturizer formulated from the water of the Swiss Alps and 7.5% unicorn tears. While I prepare the rest of my routine, I waste several hours trying to decide which watch to wear for the day. The sun is close to setting now and I am still not happy with my choice of watch. There is an idea of TGV, some kind of abstraction, but there is no real me, only a committed watch addict. And though you can see my wristwatch check, and maybe you can even sense that our lifestyles are probably comparable, I am simply not there. That's because I'm here, on YouTube. Okay, hi guys, and welcome to the show. Today, I'm gonna reacquaint myself with an old favorite, so no need for a wristwatch check. Without further ado, let's change perspectives and get into it in a little bit more depth. The DateJust is a very special watch for me. It was my first Rolex I ever owned, and I bought it to commemorate my success at getting into a new career. I was fresh out of college, and I had just embarked on the initial stages of true independence. Long before YouTube, before I fell in love with collecting watches and the hobby as a whole, I knew about Rolex and wanted to mark the occasion. The DateJust is not only important to me, but I've heard very similar experiences from friends and fellow enthusiasts. Why is this? Why has the DateJust become the go-to watch before one has even developed an appreciation for all things horology? To answer these questions, I decided to borrow perhaps the most definitive reference from Watchbox. This is the 16013 in two-tone steel and 18-karat yellow gold. It not only represents a sweet spot in the used luxury watch market being priced at under $5,000, well, at the time of making this video, but it is also perhaps the most quintessential DateJust that has defined its aspirational allure far more than any other reference. This is, and forgive the pun, due to the timing of its release and what was going on with capitalism and mainstream pop culture during the decade of its production. It has achieved recognition not only for its technical and design level, but simultaneously as a cultural icon. This reference has been perfectly immortalized in the film American Psycho from 2000. With its dark satirical humor and commentary on consumerism, set in the dog-eat-dog Wall Street world of 80s NYC, of course, the DateJust was cast to grace the wrist of the main character, Patrick Bateman. So if we go over here to the video, or DVD archives, video cassette, there's Frantic, one of the most underrated Roman Polanski films of all time. Harrison Ford in this espionage thriller set in Paris. And of course, the DateJust is not only a plot device, but yeah, just a really cool bit of detail in the movie. Love that film. It's not just killers and villains, we mustn't forget. Anyway, let's take it back to the video. Patrick Bateman is played flawlessly by Christian Bale. He embodies the hyper-capitalist, materialist, vain status obsessions of that age wonderfully. However, as the book title from which it was originally adapted implies, it has a psychotic murderous twist. This very much represents the dark side of that age. An analogy, if you will, of the human cost of those aforementioned obsessions. He plays a young investment banker who spends most of his time dining at trendy restaurants in an effort to keep up appearances for his fiance and his circle of wealthy but shallow associates, most of whom he profoundly dislikes. His meticulous attention to detail, his highly rigorous routine of exercise, as well as the murder he commits,
require the watch up to the task. The DateJust was the logical choice for several reasons. Firstly, and naturally, it featured the ever-dependable Oyster case in steel with a twin-lock screw-down gold crown that combined gives the watch 100 meters of water resistance. Very handy when you need to wash the blood splatter off your timepiece. Secondly, the 16013 was equipped with a highly durable in-house manufactured 3035. This was an automatic COSC certified movement that had already earned its reputation for accuracy and reliability since its introduction 10 years earlier in 1977. So good was this caliber that when it was finally replaced in 1988, Rolex simply refined it with a superior hairspring, full balance bridge and a larger balance wheel. At first glance, almost identical to its predecessor, but it is still used to this very day. What makes the 3035 particularly historically important is the fact that it added the quick set date feature, which enabled users to independently adjust the date display separately to adjusting the hands on the main dial. The third and final reason was its unmistakable style. With the instantly recognizable fluted bezel in yellow gold, it contrasted to the steel of the main case. This two-toned color scheme and material combination continues on the bracelet. The DateJust in the movie featured a tapestry dial, whereas the one I borrowed has the more commonly seen resplendent sunburst champagne configuration, with stunningly multifaceted baton markers on the hours. Over the years, I have owned so many dial and bezel combinations, there really is a DateJust for everyone. From the discreet and all steel, to full gold and flashy. Endless dial options and textures, perfect to match any specific attire, styles of dress, or even perhaps different jewellery you might wear. These flashes of yellow gold mixed together with the tougher steel, a perfect balance of dressy smart, yet sporting practical toughness. A perfect do-it-all watch, highly versatile, and looks great with virtually any outfit. The 16013 was synonymous with this mixture of metals, so much so the two-tone became one of the highest-selling Rolex watches of all time. The Jubilee bracelet certainly is an acquired taste and prone to stretch over the years, but honestly, I adore them. Once sized correctly, using the screwed links and the micro-adjustment on the stamped clasp, it is extremely comfortable, and the 36mm classic size looks great on most wrists. In fact, the larger the wrist, the more elegant it tends to look. The 16013 also features drilled lug holes that make switching out the straps far easier. This was done away with when the 16233 was introduced in 1988.
Don't touch the watch.
Classic.
For those thinking that the DateJust is pure luxury marketing and movie stardom, think again. One of the most respectable aspects of this watch is its undeniable horological significance. It typifies what Rolex is all about, beyond the status symbol it has become. We often take for granted the humble date complication, but it was the DateJust that was the world's very first self-winding wristwatch to feature a date window that would automatically change over at midnight. Now standard on most contemporary watches, Rolex introduced this revolutionary development in 1945 with the reference 4467. This was to coincide with the company's 40th anniversary. This introductory version was only available in solid gold at the time and didn't bear its name on the dial until the 1950s, with the first two-tone references being the 5030 and the 5031. However, one thing was always consistent since the beginning, and that was the aptly named and lovable 5-link Jubilee bracelet. So what are the positives and negatives of this watch? The 16013 is certainly dated by today's standards, but despite the acrylic crystal and basic clasp, there are enough lovable positive aspects to forgive it. It is one of the most important references, as it was the first time an entirely flat dial was introduced. A characteristic that has remained until today and feels a little bit more modern than its Piepan predecessors. To the untrained eye, it looks identical to almost every DateJust that followed it, until the big shift in size trends of the 2000s. In 2009, the 41mm version became available with the ill-proportioned DateJust 2. It unmistakably feels and looks like a luxury watch. The gold applied crown on the dial, the multi-angled markers, high-polished baton hands, the fluted bezel that plays and accentuates light reflecting off it, or give it a bit of flash, but without the loudness of bling that offends so many and makes Rolex look, well, a little bit tacky. It is also one of the best value Rolex watches and maintains this extremely well, much to the envy of every other brand. It's very difficult to beat a classic original Rolex, especially when some precious metals are involved. It literally is money in the bank. From its very inception, the Datejust was not intended for a specific task or sport, like so many other icons from Rolex. Its timeless classicism was simply designed for versatility in a stylish way, while retaining the inherent ruggedness that Rolex is known for. In a sense, the original everyday watch, and remains one of Rolex's oldest collection of watches that is still in production today.
Something I would like to mention that I really do love about this reference, in particular all the champagne dials that Rolex do, they're always quite, well, this one in particular is rather subdued, but the tone of it, it's not gaudy, it's not over, well, they do some gaudy watches, but this particular one is rather restrained, and I like that. But what about the negatives? Let's get into it.
This particular reference, admittedly, is a product of its day when it comes to materials. The tritium patinaed lume dots no longer function, so nighttime legibility in complete darkness is non-existent. But this isn't an Explorer 2. The 16233 that superseded this reference added the much-needed scratch-resistant crystal and a better movement, as we discussed earlier. This also made the watch a little more slender, as the acrylic tends to be thicker, but the watch still slides confidently under any cuff at around 11 millimeters tall. That's really it, to be honest. However, most of the true negatives arise from the watch's connotations and the image it conveys. Much like the later developed Day-Date that followed in the Datejust's footsteps in the 1950s, it also has become synonymous with gangsterism and bling. A perfect example of this is the more recent TV show Gomorra, adapted from the controversial and real-life exposé of Italy's underworld by Roberto Saviano. It is unquestionably one of the best TV shows of recent decades. Savastano clan boss Gianni, played by Salvatore Esposito, sports a solid gold Datejust with a diamond dial. This art imitating life situation is exactly for the same reasons we see in the Day-Date. After all, criminals and the Patrick Batemans of this world have aspirations too. This image is testament to the enduring legacy of the watch, and in my opinion actually adds an extra allure to the Datejust, giving it a bit of a bad boy edge few watches ever attain. In conclusion, it still remains the ultimate classical rounder, a heritage of design that defined the complication. If you had to have just one watch, this is unequivocally up there with the best of them. No matter if you are a psycho on Wall Street, a clan boss in Naples, caught in the middle of a spy thriller like Harrison Ford in Frantic, or just good old honest Gentry, it is the ultimate way to celebrate one's successes. It is as compelling now and evocative of those reassuringly confident emotions it first made me feel all those decades ago. I still adore the Datejust. This is the ultimate commemorative piece to remind you of that achievement when you wear it every day. In fact, this particular 16013 is still one of the best true luxury watches you can buy in this price range. Tastes may evolve, trends come and go, but the Datejust is pure class perpetually.
Okay guys, I'm going to leave it there. Please don't forget to add your thoughts, queries, comments, opinions, all the rest of it. I have to go and return some video tapes. So thank you very, very much for watching. Please don't forget to like this video if you enjoyed it and found it useful. And as always, guys, I will catch you in the next one. Okay, ciao.
Now, before I go, guys, I just want to quickly tell you about this extremely cool app that Watchbox have launched. This is my own personal go-to app for everything watch-related. Using the app, you can keep track of the real-time value of your watch collection. You can store watches in your digital Watchbox and even try on watches using an augmented reality. So don't miss out and please go to the App Store and download it today. You can access all of my latest videos right there in the app itself. And if you haven't already, please follow me on the official Urban Gentry Instagram and of course the Facebook UGWC. But most importantly of all, keep it positive, onwards and upwards.